Hi, when it comes to filling up a pool or topping a pool up, most people would use tap water because of its convenience. But here in the UK, that would definitely be a bit of a mistake because it contains high levels of phosphate. Now, phosphate is a key limiting nutrient for algae. So if you put more phosphate in, you're going to get a load of algae in the pool. The best water you can use is rainwater. And ideally, the rainwater that falls directly on the surface of the pool. However, that may not be available in great enough quantities to serve your pool's needs over the year. So a better solution, a more practical solution, is to gather roof water. So roof water is pretty low in nutrients, except for the first flush that comes off the roof after a long period of dry weather. Then you'll have detritus and dust, other materials, and they will go flooding into the pool and provide nutrients which may then feed algae. So what we need to do is to divert that first flush of nutrient-rich water from the roof. So we end up with a device like this, or this is my device. We've got a mechanical tipping device here, holding a bit of guttering, some more guttering here, and some more rainwater pipe in this sort of strange configuration. It also pivots on something like this. Now I use bicycle pedals because they're really, really strong. Yeah, and that's not going to go anywhere. Nice right angle bend to that, so you can fix that to a piece of wood, which is exactly what I've done there. Yeah, so that's fixed into there, and then another piece of wood resting on top. So that's the basis of it, this pedal. Okay, well, pretend there's a roof here, like the roof of that shed comes down into this hopper. Let's give it some rain, shall we? There we go. So we've got rain flooding in. Take some more out of that. And what's happening here is rain's coming down through the pipe, and then because of the angle of this, it's tipping down this way, and the water comes down here and starts to fill this jug. This is a nice old enamel jug, and I just thought it looked quite nice, but a bucket or something more prosaic will do. What I did have to do with this, however, is drill a hole in here, because I've put a pipe in there so that this pipe will actually drain out the water from the jug. And the reason for that is we want this whole thing to reset in the end. And this is actually a sort of cunning bit of stuff. And so that's probably one of the highlights of the video, actually, me just sort of explaining what that little pipe does. But it'll be a bit hard in this shot to illustrate it. So at the moment, water's coming down, and there we go. Right. Now, water's now tipped down this way and been diverted into this tank. And this tank I call my rainwater diverter tank, or rainwater diverter tank, if I could say it. Okay, so water is entering here and obviously raising the level in this tank. But this tank is connected hydraulically to the pool. And I've illustrated it by saying pool on this tank. So when the water level starts to rise in here, it's actually making the water level rise in the pool, albeit very slowly in a real life situation, because the volume of this will be massive. So any water is coming in and entering the pool. But what we don't want is when the pool is full, we don't want any more water to be entering the pool, you know, from the roof. Because even though this cleans roof water, because this is now effectively cleaned, or this is after the first flush, even that will contain nutrients. So there's no point in continuing to add nutrients into the pool. So you want to stop that. So that's where this comes in. Oh, that's now nicely reset itself. But what is happening in this tank is that when the water level in the pond is low, then water will come down, fill this up, and then water will go into the pond. So when the pool is full, we don't want any more water entering it. There's no need. So this tank here will actually divert the water. So I'll just simulate it by... we'll get some more rain going. Yeah. And if I just top up the pool here, let's even get this to do it in real life. Yeah. More rain's coming in. Lots of rain. First flush been taken away. Then it goes into this rainwater tank, secondary diverter. And we get to a point where the pool level is high enough. And, I don't know if you can see here, now water is flowing out of this. So this excess water that's coming in, which we don't need because the pool is full, is now being diverted down this pipe and into the bucket. So the pool level is staying the same and excess water is being taken away. So there we go. There's like two levels there of rainwater diverting going on. And the other thing about this is, if you wanted to lower the level in the pool, this tank is effectively your overflow drain. It replaces the overflow drain you would have in a pool. And so if I just tip this down, more water will come out, and that's lowering the water level in the tank, which is also lowering the water level in the pool. And it will only stop flowing when the water level in the pool has gone down to whatever height this pipe has determined. So you've got some control over the pool water level. Say you wanted to drop it to put some plants in or whatever. So there we go. Rainwater diverter. I first made one of these about 10 years ago and I thought it was about time for a bit of an update. Anyway, there we go. It's off again. You know, once it starts going, you can't stop it. Okay, if I just show you what's going on in here, we've got this piece of silicone pipe. Hole is drilled there, it goes down into the bottom and sits nice and snugly down in the bottom of that jug. And at the end of it, I put a T-fitting, and that's so that there's less chance of it getting blocked up with detritus. That gunk at the bottom there. When the water level increases above the pipe level, then water flows out the pipe. As it drops down, this pipe then acts as a siphon, so it sucks out the last of it. So there's a subtlety of design. You get wet messing around with water. Thank you.